Hello and welcome to the how-to guide for Simon Says, the Twitch Plays like app that I've been working on for quite some time. Project started in August 2022. Version one was quite successful, and this version two is so much better. Very, very feature rich and very exciting. So let's see how we can download it, get it installed, and use it. So if you are watching this video from the README here, you'll already be in the right place. But if someone's just shared this video to you, then you need to go to github.com/howroyd/SimonSays. I'll put a link in the description for that. And that'll take you to the homepage of the whole project. Lots of code and stuff. It's all open source. So if you want to have a look through the code yourself and do some learning, it's all in Python. So you'd be very welcome to do that. And then we've got the README down here. Key thing to look out for is these green passing marks and the green tick here. If they turn into red and red crosses, then that typically means that the latest version may be broken. So don't update. The software does not auto update. You have to manually come and download the new version yourself. So you can always stick on a known working version and get no surprises before you stream or whatever. So to get the software, on the right-hand side, you can see releases here. And the one that should be always shown is the one that has this green latest tag on the right-hand side here. You can either click that straight away or you can click releases and it will take you and you can see every single release that's ever been done, including all my old test releases, version one, and so on. But this is the latest one with this green latest tag. That's what you're looking for, unless you want to download an earlier version. At the bottom here, we can see assets. If that's collapsed, just click the little triangle to expand it out. And we have the Linux release as a gzip tarball if you are playing some Linux game or want to play about with that. But I would imagine most people who know me through Phasmophobia will be playing Phas, which is Windows only at the time of release. I wonder if that'll change in the future. So you've got a zip file here. So we can click that, download it. It's downloading now into Chrome. And bang, there it is. And I'm just going to drag it straight onto my desktop. You can put this wherever you wish. It's not installed into Windows or anything like that. So I'm just going to extract it straight onto my desktop. And then Windows security has decided to have a bit of a wobble. You'll get that. There's an explanation down in the README as to why Windows Defender throws a hissy fit. Long and short of it is you have to pay Microsoft for an exception, sort of like a certificate or a license. You just basically have to give them money to stop it doing that, which is, yeah, I have opinions. But anyway, it's all the source code is open anyway, so you can read through it yourself and do your own due diligence. So we now have the unzips folder. We can get rid of the zip one, so let's get rid of that. And in here, you will see the executable. If it's Windows, if you're on Linux, it's just a binary that you can run. But for Windows, we have the version number in here as well. So if you've got different versions all downloaded, you know, if there's updates in the future and so on, you can differentiate. When we double-click this, again, Windows Defender will throw a wobble, and we can load it up. And it's slow because Windows Defender is doing a scan because it's the first time I've opened this. I find that once you've done it once, It sort of doesn't care after that. That was painfully slow to load. Just to give you an idea, and let's hope I can prove myself right here. If we open this again. Yeah, it opened almost instantly. So that was Windows Defender doing some scanning and stuff. So we get two windows. Let's get rid of that. You get this console window, and you get this new GUI that you didn't get in version one. It's okay. It's not the prettiest GUI. I'm not a GUI person, so it looks a bit janky. But you know, this is the first GUI I've ever made, so cut me some slack. I'm an embedded guy. In this window, the interesting thing here is the list of valid commands. So if you have Nightbot or Stream Elements or whatever, and you want to make a command in your chat that just lists everything that your viewers can type, you've got it here. If you change any of these commands, you do have to restart the software to get this to print out again with the correct things. So this isn't live updated, it's only sequential. We can see here that we have connected the Twitch channel. The default is my channel. That's just how the config file defaults to here. So you're going to, first of all, want to connect to your own channel, right? So we'll close the software, we'll open it up, and what you'll notice is in this folder, we have now got a config.toml file. And there's also this backup here. If you ever need a backup, it's just the same. It's just the old version if anything changes. But you can open this in Notepad, or in my case, in Notepad++. Or you can open it in Word if you prefer Word or WordPad. Whatever, it's just a text file. And this is pretty much the only time you will ever need to go into this file now. Version 1, this was your interface to change things. This new version, you can do everything through the GUI except for the channel. Maybe that'll change in the future. But right at the top here, you can see, can I zoom in on this a little bit? Yeah, lovely. So we can see Dr. Green Giant. So if you wanted to change this to your own channel, let's say HPX Streamer, you can just change that, save, and start software again. And you'll notice here that we have now connected to HPX Streamer, and it also tells you on the GUI in the top left as well, which channel you connected to. If you want to do a collab and you want to connect to multiple channels chats at the same time, so say, for example, I was doing a collab with Dreamer and I wanted, if someone types in my chat, it affects my keyboard as normal, but also if they type something in Dreamer's chat, it also affects my keyboard, so I need to connect to two different chats. You can just stick a comma and then stick another channel in here, like that, in quotes. And you can have as many of these as you like if you're doing a four-way collab, for example. Case doesn't matter. It'll automatically convert everything to lowercase because that's actually what the Twitch chat uses anyway behind the scenes. So don't worry about that. The only other thing you're likely to need to touch in this file is the bots here. We'll talk bit about this later on, but if you have bots and you want them to be able to interact, and there's a fun feature, then you can add the name of your bot in here. So by default, we've got Streamlabs, Stream Elements, Nightbot, and Butspot, and we'll see what the effect of that is later. So we'll save that config file, and now we can just go straight into the software. We don't need to look at that anymore. So right at the top, we can click this button and it gives you the list of commands. Before we do that, I would like to encourage you to notice this button enabled at the bottom. By default, the software starts enabled. So if someone types in my chat now as I am speaking a valid command, it is going to press a button on my keyboard or click my mouse or move my mouse. You probably want to click this and disable. And you will see the positive feedback in the chat here. This means now that the outputs will not happen. It'll still be reading chat. You'll still see things popping up in here, but nothing will happen. So if you've tabbed out of your game and you are in OBS, for example, you probably don't want people pressing buttons on your keyboard whilst you're in OBS. The way this works is it is as if someone has plugged in a second keyboard and a second mouse into your computer and is pressing buttons. So, you know, in Windows, it depends. Whichever window is in the foreground, that's the thing it's going to type stuff into and click and so on. So I would encourage you when you tab out of the game to just smash this disabled button. And then when you're ready to tab back in, you can re-enable like this. We don't want any unforeseen problems. There are no commands that do Alt F4 or anything like that, or Control Escape or any of those sorts of things. But you know that there are keybinds in various bits of software, so it depends. So we can select a command. So let's just pick the first one, forward, here. And we've got a few options in this beautiful looking box. First of all, we can just completely disable the command. Now it's as if it doesn't exist. There is no forward command anymore because we've unticked this box. I'm not your supervisor, but maybe some of the more spicy ones towards the bottom of the list you may be uncomfortable with, you can just straight up disable them. But let's leave that enabled for now. Next up is the command. So this is what you need to type in Twitch chat to make the thing happen. It needs to be at the start of the message, no exclamation mark or anything like that. So I would just type forward in chat. That's it. Actually, anything after the word forward will just be ignored. So you could write forward space please, and it would still do forward because the message starts with this command. So likewise, if someone typed forwards, you know, with an S at the end, it would still just work because the message begins with forward. Next up, we've got the keybind. This is fairly hot off the press, so it doesn't look quite as pretty as I want it to, but for now it gets the job done. So if you want to change your keybind and say you want to use spacebar to move forwards, we can click this button. And what you will notice is in this log here, it will say starting keyboard and mouse listeners. So now the next time I click a button on my mouse or press a key on my keyboard, it will register that as the keybind, just like pretty much every game and bit of software does, right? So if I press spacebar, what you'll see in the log is, first of all, it stopped listening. So we've stopped logging your keyboard and your mouse now. It detected that you pressed spacebar for action forward. So it set the keybind to space. And really, in the GUI is the important thing. You can see keyboard space. Now, if you're completely crazy, mad, whatever you want to be, and you want to use middle mouse for forwards, you can do that. So we can click set keybind. Notice it says it's listening. Now I'm going to click middle mouse on my mouse. And you'll notice it says now mouse button, and the button is middle. What you might notice is there's also some special keys, like I have a few thumb buttons on my mouse. Some of them count as a mouse button, so there's X2 and X1 in Windows, and some of them are actually just macros to keyboard buttons. So if I press one of the thumb buttons on my mouse, and I have Stardew music playing there, it's the media play pause button. Even though it's on the mouse, it is actually, as far as Windows is concerned, it's a keyboard button. So just if you get a bit confused there, it still just works as normal. And as you saw then, it just started playing there, started playing some music. So I'll close that. Then we have these two sliders. These are your cooldown and random chance. Cooldown, hopefully self-explanatory. If cooldown is zero and two people type the same command one after the other, they will both work. The only time they won't is if one is in progress. When someone else types the same command, it will ignore it because it is already being done. But if they type it right after it finishes, so for example, forward is by default 3 seconds, it will press and hold W or whatever keybind you got for 3 seconds and then let go. And if someone types forward again, it will just immediately accept that command. But if it's during the 3 seconds, it just blank gets ignored. Things don't get queued up, put it that way. We have the random chance. So this is probably more for spicy commands, to be honest. Otherwise, it's just going to get a bit spammy in chat. But again, I'm not your supervisor. If I set this to 50, then it means that when this command runs, if it is eligible to run, so it's not on cooldown and it's not currently running and so on and so forth, we roll a dice, two-sided dice, or flip a coin, I suppose. And if you win, the command will execute. If you lose, it will not. And you will actually see in this window, you get the feedback from it. You'll say, command failed to execute, random chance, which means basically it failed the dice roll. That does reset the cooldown now. It didn't in version 1. So for the spicy commands, if someone tries it and they fail the roll, it resets the cooldown, so they then have to wait another 30 seconds or whatever it is before they can try again. There was a bug in version 1 where basically if the roll failed, it didn't reset the cooldown, so you could just spam it until you won the roll, which was quite funny. So that's that. So, tell you what, before we move on, let's just set this back to W before I confuse myself. You've got sprint here as well. Sprint works, shift L is your left shift button. That's just what it's called. You can also do other special keys if you wish. So personally, I don't use C for crouch. I use left control. So we'll set keybind and I press left control. There we go. We're bound to left control now. Easy as that. And also, I'm going to change some of my keybinds here. So I like using R for the journal. And if you do press it by mistake, don't press escape, because escape is a valid key. You just have to press the button again. At some point, I will add some feedback into this so you can see in the GUI if it's listening or not. But for the moment, you've just got to look in here. You only have to do this once, by the way, because it all gets saved into the config. And the other one I personally change is the torque. So I don't use V for push to torque. I actually use the thumb button on my mouse, which is apparently X1. That one's quite good fun. Because particularly in Phasmophobia, when the ghost is hunting, you don't press your push to talk button, otherwise it hears you. But it's normally a good time to speak to chat, but if someone types talk in chat, then they've just pressed your push to talk for you. So exciting times. Then we get to the spicy commands, which are towards the bottom. These don't have keybinds associated to them because they are sequences. So, for example, if we go to teabag, right, teabag just crouches you and uncrouches you actually for a random number of times. So there is no keybind for this because it uses the crouch command. So you only have to change crouch and then teabag automatically updates itself here as well. And that's it. Just to prove the point then, so crouch I have set to left control rather than C. So if I close the software, that gets saved into this config file. So if you download an update, you, all being well, and assuming I've not broken anything, can just copy your config file over to your the new folder with your new version, or you can just put your new version exe in here as well if you wish, and you have a backup there too. I would recommend, if you spend a load of time changing this file, just save a backup somewhere, just in case. So I open this again, and if we go to crouch, you can see it's remembered left control, right? What you would expect. And if we change some of these words that you would type in chat as well, it would do that too. So without further ado, what we're going to do now is jump into a quick bit of FAS. I'll show you what it looks like when it's running. I've got my chat up here. In fact, I will pull it up on my phone because I'm obviously not going to be able to tab out when we're in game. But just to show you, you know, what happens if you're tabbed into another window. If I type forward now, notice how it's just pressed W in chat here, right? Because that's what forward is. That's the keybind for it. Likewise, if I press use, I think use is right mouse button. And you can see it's pulled up the right mouse button. So you probably don't want that happening. So if I disable and then try and do forward, you'll see nothing happened. And for peace of mind, you can see in the console window, for example, using forward, running use, blah, blah, blah. Then we disabled, and it says command disabled, ignoring forward from Dr. Green Giant, right? Because we're disabled. So that gives you the peace of mind that it's not going to do anything when you don't expect it to, hopefully. So we'll re-enable, and let's just quickly pull up FAS as a quick example. But at this point, you've seen everything you need to see. So stay about if you wish. Okay. So here we are in the lobby, and I'm going to just stand here and I'm going to type forward in chat, which failed random chance. Interesting. Oh, because I've still got the random chance set to 50. Ah, well done. So this is what you see. That's good example, right? So what I did, I just put some underscores just so you can see. On mobile, it capitalizes the first letter. That doesn't matter. It converts everything to lowercase, so you don't have to worry about case. Because the random chance was 50-50, and I just got unlucky, this is the message you will see. Failed forward from Green Giant. Result is random chance, so it failed the random chance. So if I make the random chance 100, and let's just drag that back over, and I type forward again in chat, you can see we start walking forwards, and that's 3 seconds. If I go all the way over here, and I've just used up my sprint, so there we are, and I do sprints forward, you can see we are sprinting forward. We covered significantly more ground there, and then you heard the out of breath sound there too. If something's on cooldown, so I'm just going to stick the cooldown for forward to like 10 minutes or whatever that is, 5 minutes, and try forward again. So I've just set, this is all in seconds, by the way, that's seconds, that's percentage, so standard units. You can see we got the message here that you would expect. Failed forward from Green Giant. Result is on cooldown. I might tidy this log message up at some point as well. We'll see. That's more for me than anyone, to be frank. You've got the other ones like spin. So you can do mouse stuff. you've got look left, for example. You've got There's a few different mouse move ones. You can try them all out in your own time, but they're really good fun. I'll show you teabag since we were talking about that before. So there's teabag. And just to show you, this is what I've been typing in chat. So we did sprint forwards, forward, sorry, sprint forward, look left, teabag, spin. All that sort of stuff. If you've seen version one, that should be reasonably familiar. And that's it. So I'm going to tab out, and the first thing I'm going to do is hit that disable, the enable button, so it's now disabled. So now if one of my trolley chats decides to type in my chat, it's not going to do something weird. And let's just quit. So that's it. If you would like to contribute to the code or to the artwork, thank you to the wonderful Sheenie for this beautiful background that I've gone and stuck this disgusting grey text box over. I will figure out how to make that semi-transparent one day, but this is the actual original fantastic stuff with things I do. I'm a beekeeper. I had chickens. I work in UAVs. Last year, I grew pumpkins and I grow mushrooms at home as well. Pink oysters, they are. And it's just a generic one. So, if you would like to contribute, the best way is going to the GitHub, go to the project. You can raise a discussion. This is like a sort of a discussion forum. You can just start a new thing. You can give, suggestions or whatever. Really, the best place for bugs and feature requests and things like that is the Issues tab, and you can click New Issue here. You can file a bug report or a feature request or a vulnerability if you find one. This repository gets scanned weekly. Well, on every update I do, but also weekly. If I get hit by a bus or whatever, it will still do these checks for vulnerability. But yeah, say you want a new feature, say you want it to work with a completely different game. So you want me to add some new keybinds or make it easier to sorry, actions or make it easier to add your own things. Then we can do that. So type whatever you want in here. Don't worry too much about it being formal. Just put your ideas down on the page and then submit new issue. And that'll pop up and I'll see this straight away. Pretty much. So that's it. If you want to contribute to the repository, as I say, it's all open source. So if you want to get into this, please do feel free. All the code is here. It's all here to be seen and to be played with. And it's quite a lot, but I've done an okay job. So you can see we've got walk forward, walk back, walk left, so on. Or if you want to contribute some design work for the GUI, for the user interface or something, it would be nice to make this pretty. I'm just not very good at that sort of thing. So let me know. Let me know your thoughts. Enjoy. If you get stuck, please do let me know. You can drop me a maybe a whisper on Switch if I don't know if that even works anymore. I'm not sure how that works. You can drop me a message through here. If you want to support financially, you can through here, but it's free to use. So I expect nothing towards that. If you do contribute, you will show up here forevermore as a contributor. And have a read. Through the README, you can see where this project started, the inspiration, people I've referenced and taken code from, and so on and so forth. You can, if you wish, download the repository. If you're into GitHub and you know that sort of thing, you can clone the repository and you can run this as a Python module. So you can play about, do your own stuff, fork the repository, and make your own thing. That is absolutely fine. Just follow the usual licensing. It's GPL version 2, so it's a pretty accessible license. It allows you to more or less do what you want, but all the details are here anyway. Enjoy. Let me know what you think. See you soon.